God help me. When they got ready, took this apart from me, to use the sacrifice, Jesus. Jesus. The Bible said, take the sacrifice. He said, take the sacrifice and tie it up. Take your flesh and tie it up. Because when they got ready to slay the sacrifice, they brought them to the brazen altar already dead. In the Old Testament, they would take them in the outer court and they would slit their throats from ear to ear. And then they would take them and they would sit them over on top of the brazen altar. But then the Bible said in Romans, Jesus, 12 and 1, the reason why God spoke in Psalms 118 and said to tie the sacrifice to the altar, because Romans 12 said, present your body a living sacrifice. And God knew that there was coming a time that your flesh was going to wrestle against God, and your flesh was not going to want to die, and your flesh was going to wrestle with the will of God. So God said, I'm going to help you. I'm going to tie you to the brazen altar. Give me cord as I walk up the board. Let it go around. Let it go around. Give me cord. Hurry up. Give me cord. Give me cord. Because he knew that some of y'all was going to want to leave the church. And some of y'all was going to want to leave your prayer life. And some of y'all wasn't going to want to stay. Hold up. Fix the cord. Some of y'all wasn't going to want to stay. Some of y'all was gonna let a boyfriend cause you to leave God. Some of y'all was gonna, oh my God, was gonna let a girlfriend tell you, baby, why you going to that conference? You think you so deep. I don't know why you doing all that praying. He knew it. He knew somebody was gonna convince you to get up your prayer life and stop fasting and stop praying. He knew that somebody was gonna persecute you and your flesh was gonna get tired. So he said, tie your body to the altar. He said, because it's coming. He said, it's coming. He said, it's coming. He said, because after a while, lift the cord up. He said, after a while, he said, your turn is coming. Your turn is coming. That God is going to have you tied. Come on, little boy. Come around here. He said, it's coming. Pick me up. That the Holy Ghost was going to call you. And that turn is tonight. Your season is here. That's why you came. You didn't come for your ministry to be anointed. You didn't come to God to do something for your gift. You came in tonight because you are a sacrificer. It's time for God to put you. Come on, put you over inside. Let me say this. Look at I can't get out by myself. God put you in, but I can't climb out by myself. My fine twine linen won't let me get out. Oh, I'm not hearing nobody say that. It's your pent after righteousness that causes you to put your life on the brazen altar. Good God have mercy. And the Bible said that the fire stayed lit for 900 years and the fire never went out. And the reason why it never went out, because every single day, as a matter of fact, every minute, according to correct calculations, another sacrifice was being laid on the brazen altar. And that's why the church have lost her fire, because every minute somebody else ought to be getting on the sacrifice so the fire of God can stay lit in the church. And so somebody said, well, you know what, God sent Jesus and he was the ultimate sacrifice. But yeah, Paul said, but I die daily. Yes, Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice. He's the ultimate sacrifice. But there's something about you, because your will keeps getting in God's way. What you think keeps getting in God's way. Yes, God has a ministry for you, but God can't raise you up, because he's not raising up flesh. He's killing flesh. He's burning flesh up. Flesh can't go up. Flesh can't preach to his people, because in the last days, I'm giving my people my ear, and a stranger, they will not follow. They will not follow the flesh. So, get on top. Yes, so let me tell you now. Let me tell you something. Where we are now, he said of the board that Abihu and Nadab went and got them some fire. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Some of y'all done went and got you some tongues. Some of y'all done went and got you a gift. Oh, you don't want to talk back to me in here. Some of y'all went and got you a little Holy Ghost. But I guarantee you what you got, you can't stay saved 1 week, because it ain't the real thing. I'm not hearing nobody say nothing. Some of y'all done went and got y'all something. Some of y'all done went and got y'all something that God ain't gave you, because you didn't get it on the altar. It ain't pure. That's why you preach mad. That's why you can't take nothing. That's why you can't take rebuke. That's why you can't take correction, because you've never been in the fire. But anybody that's ever been in the fire, honey, they can stand to be corrected. They can take the heat. I'm not giving nobody say nothing. Anybody in here that's ever been to the brazen altar, they know what it means. Oh, God. They know what it means. Something is about to hit this place. Something is about to hit this place. Something is about to hit this place. Good God have mercy. And God told me tonight, you can't go any further. We can't do nothing else in this conference until everybody in this building that's got fine twine linen on, everybody that's got on white,